2. Plants, structure and function. Let's recall. What helps us to easily identify the plants around us? The root, stem, leaves, flowers, fruits, etc. of different plants are different. We can identify plants with the help of these different characteristics. Let us now acquaint ourselves with these plant organs in greater detail. Root. Try this. Activity 1. Keep a moistened ball of crumpled paper in a conical flask. Place some soaked mote beans, that is gram seeds, in the flask between the paper and the glass wall. Observe and note the changes in the seeds in 2 or 3 days. The part that grows from inside the seed towards the soil is called the radicle, and the part that grows above the soil is called the plumule. The root that forms from the radicle grows into the ground. The root is thick near the ground and gradually tapers to a pointed end. This part of the plant growing below the soil for support is called root. Roots of some plants produce secondary roots that grow obliquely and spread far and wide in the soil. Roots support the plant. This type of root is called a tap root. Roots bear hair-like processes near the root tips. These are root hairs. The root tip is delicate. This is the region of the growth of the root. The tip is covered by cap-like structure called the root cap. The root cap protects the root tip from injuries. Activity 2. Take a glass jar and fill 3/4 of it with water. Place an onion on the mouth of the jar in such a way that its roots are towards the water. Observe the growth of the roots for 8 days. Thread-like or fiber-like roots arising from the stem are called fibrous roots. Thus, there are 2 main types of roots, tap roots and fibrous roots. Dicotyledonous plants have tap roots, while monocotyledonous plants have fibrous roots. Activity 3. Sow the seeds of plants like mustard, sorghum, that is jowar, maize, that is corn, pea, coriander, etc. in an earthen pot. Cultivate the plants for 8 days. Once the plants grow 15 to 20 centimeters high, uproot them carefully while the soil is moist and put them gently in a large conical flask containing water. The soil will get washed off without any harm to the roots. Observe the roots carefully to see which plants have tap roots and which ones have fibrous roots.
Plants like maize, sugarcane, sorghum have 2 types of roots. Some roots are underground, whereas some grow from the stem just above the soil. The latter are called adventitious roots. Besides the normal functions like absorption of water and minerals, anchoring and supporting the plant, roots perform some other functions too. Roots show some modifications to perform these additional functions. Some examples of such modified roots are aerial roots, stilt roots, runners, breathing roots, that is, pneumatophores, etc. Activity 4. Take some water in a small glass jar. Put a plantlet in it in such a way that its roots are dipped in the water. Mark the water level on the jar and add 5 milliliters of oil to the water. Record the water level on the next day. Discuss your observations in the class.
Use your brain power. 1. What would have happened if plants like tamarind, banyan and mango had fibrous roots? Answer. If plants like tamarind, banyan and mango had fibrous roots, they would not stand erect and grow so huge. 2. What will happen if the root tip is injured? Answer. If the root tip is injured, the root system will become weak and cannot absorb sufficient water. 3. Which types of roots do the fenugreek, spinach and onion plants have? Answer. Fenugreek and spinach have taproot, whereas onion plant has fibrous roots. Do you know? Roots emerging from the trunk and branches of a banyan tree grow towards the soil. These roots are called prop roots. What could be the use of these prop roots? These prop roots are used for additional support. Prop roots means an aerial root that arises from a stem or trunk and penetrates the soil. In the beginning, the banyan tree has very few prop roots, but later on, their number increases so much that it appears like a small forest. In Kolkata, a 250 years old banyan tree in the Indian Botanical Garden covers a very large area. It is supported by thousands of prop roots. Is there any such tree in your neighborhood? Find out. Why are the underground parts of plants like radish, carrot, beet and sweet potato thick, fleshy and swollen? Which part of the plant are they? The underground parts of plants like radish, carrot, beet and sweet potato are thick, fleshy and swollen due to storage of food. These underground parts are nothing but the stem of the plant. Techno support. Collect images of different types of roots and send them to your friends via email. Stem. The stem grows above the soil from the plumule of the sprouting seed. As the sprout grows, the length of the stem gradually increases too. There are nodes on the stem. Leaves come out at the nodes. The part of the stem between two nodes is called an internode. The tip of the apical end of the stem is called a bud. Observe a branch of any plant and identify its different parts as per the diagram. Complete the chart. Collect information about other local plants too. In this chart, we have name of plant, thickness, that is circumference of node in millimeters, length of internode in millimeters, name of the plant 1. Sugarcane, 2. Fenugreek, 3. Leaf. Leaves grow from the nodes on a stem. Leaves are generally thin, flat and green in color. The broad spread out part of the leaf is called the leaf blade or lamina, and its edge is called the leaf margin. Leaf margins may be entire, dentate or lobed. The tip of the leaf is called the leaf apex.